Rama listened to the monkey. Let's see. Who were the characters? Narayan, grandmother, Ramanna, then Rudrappa, Kannan, they were the village men. Then Sagar, he is the building contractor. Then Dikshit, he is the millionaire, rich person, the businessman. So Narayan is the school headmaster. So then this play takes place in a small village. So here in the first scene we can see the grandmother. She came on the stage. The character is the, then who is the building contractor? Who came that village to build a 5-star hotel? So then what happens? Yes, these villagers, they were not supported to build a 5-star hotel on Dharmagiri. Here Ramanna says that he is opposing the plan of Sagar. Why? Because he says that this Dharmagiri is a beautiful mountain, so they don't want to ruin that village. Then Kannan supported the concept. Kannan is the village man. He supported the concept. He says that yes, if the building came there, it will bring tourism, means they will get more money. But then what happens? Shastri is the village man. He says that the 5-star hotel can never build up on Dharmagiri. Then Narayan asks, why do you say never? Then Shastri says that I said so because I heard it from my grandfather when 300 years ago they built a temple there. Then the builders realized that this mountain cannot support the building, which was more than 30 feet taller. മനസ്സിലായല്ലോ. അപ്പോ കണ്ണൻ അരെ വില്ലേജ് മെന്നാണ്. അപ്പോ കണ്ണന് ഇതിന് സപ്പോർട്ട് ചെയ്യുന്നില്ല. ഇവിടെ ബിൽഡിംഗ് വരാൻ, ഫസ്റ്റ് ഹോട്ടലിൽ ധർമ്മഗിരിയിൽ വരാൻ കണ്ണൻ സപ്പോർട്ട് ചെയ്യുന്നില്ല. അപ്പോഴും നാരായൺ ചോദിക്കുന്നത് എന്തുകൊണ്ടാണ് സപ്പോർട്ട് ചെയ്യാത്തത്, എന്തുകൊണ്ടാണ് ഇങ്ങനെ പറയുന്നതെന്ന് ചോദിച്ചപ്പോൾ ശാസ്ത്രി പറയുകയാണ്, എന്താണ് പറയുന്നത്? ആ, എൻ്റെ പിന്നെ ഗ്രാൻഡ് ഫാദർ പറഞ്ഞിട്ടുണ്ട്, ഇവിടെ ഈ മൗണ്ടെയിനിൽ 30 feet ഉയരത്തിലുള്ള ബിൽഡിംഗ് വന്നാൽ ഈ മലയ്ക്ക് അതിനെ താങ്ങാനുള്ള കഴിവില്ല എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞിട്ടുണ്ട്. അതുകൊണ്ട് ഇവിടെ 5-star ഹോട്ടൽ വരാൻ പാടില്ല. അതാണ് ആര് പറയുന്നത്? യെസ്, ശാസ്ത്രി പറയുന്നത് അല്ലേ. നെക്സ്റ്റ്, ദെൻ വാട്ട് ഹാപ്പൻസ്? ദെൻ Narayan decided to meet Sagar, isn't it? Why? Now he get the reason to stop the construction of 5-star hotel there. He got the reason. Shastri told no like that. So he decided to meet Dikshit. So the village people joined with him. Then they decided to meet Sagar. Okay, up to there we are discussed in the last class. Next, let us continue the lesson drama. All of you, look at the page number 86. Scene 4. With Narayan and stands in front of the curtain. Grandmother, tell me what happened. Narayan, the villagers don't want the hotel. We went to Mr. Sagar and explained that not only would our village be ruined, but the mountain itself was in danger. They cannot dig a deep foundation on it. Now, in the fourth scene, grandmother, she hobbles on the stage. She come on to the stage with Narayan and stand in front of the curtain. She asked, tell me what happened. Then Narayan says that we met Mr. Sagar. Then we explained that not only would our village ruined, but the mountain itself was in danger. Then they cannot dig a deep foundation on it. Then grandmother, what did Sagar say? Narayan, he was annoyed. So Narayan says that he was annoyed. So he get angry. Do you village bumpkins know more than the engineers and architects from the big cities? He asked. Then Sagar said that do the village peoples know more than the architects or engineers from the big cities? They are starting work tomorrow. Appol Narayan grandmother choikkun endayi poyitte karyangalella endayi nu choichappo Narayan parayukayanu endu pinne are do you village bumpkins know appo are Sagar parnu endu ningalku engineer ne kaalum koodal ariyamennanu Sagar choichathu nammalkku nu parayunu. Then grandmother, sadly, where will they go? The rabbits, the deer and the factory. Who will listen to their plight? Who will listen to our river, our clean, beautiful, sweet watered river that will now turn foul with the filth? And who will listen to the sorrow of Dharmagiri when it is massacred by roads and buildings? Then what happens then? Yes, grandmother felt so sad. She says that where did the rabbits, then yes, deer and the other birds, where did they go? Who will listen to their plight? Who will listen to their problems? Who will listen to our river, our sacred river, then clean, then beautiful river, sweet watered river? It will turn into dirty. And who will listen to the sorrow of Dharmagiri when it is massacred by roads and buildings? Yes, then he says that the hill suffer because of these buildings and roads. The noise, the pollution, hoard. You think I am crazy because I care for these things, because I can hear their voice. Don't believe me if you don't want to. Yes, I love them. I love that birds and animals. She says like that. Okay, I know that I can hear their sounds, voice. But I know the mountains, the rivers, the trees and the animals, they all speak just like you and me. If only we listen to them, then she says that yes, the mountains, the rivers, the birds, trees, animals, they all speak. Yes, just like me or you. If we, yes, watch them, listen them carefully. But the world is now is full of noise. How can anyone hear the softly gurgling stream or the breeze as it rustles through the leaves or the flutter of a bird's wings? Appol grandmother chindikkunnathu aare pattiyanu avadulla animals name birds name mountains name pattiyanu chindikkunnathu ippo endanna ivide 5 star hotel pinne vannale endu sambhavikkum alle appo ee birds pinne mountain alle nashichu povu alle appo pinne buildings vannale pinne noise aayirkum pollution aayirkum appo nammude grandmother totally upset aanu. Then Narayan. Now Adi, Adi means here grandmother, don't get upset. Narayan consoled her. Grandmother, wiping her eyes, I know, what has the hotel got to do with me? She turned to her grandson. You know something, this has more to do with the children of our village than anyone else. Tomorrow's world is their world. Tomorrow's world is their world. So they, you are the school headmaster. You must talk to the children. Find out what they feel about it. Don't put ideas into their head. Just tell them everything and let them think for themselves. Then grandmother says to her grandson Narayan. She said that you are the school headmaster, you have to tell all these things to the children, but don't put ideas to their heads. Only you just tell them everything. Okay, then let them think for themselves, means let them think individually. They go off stage through left hand and re-enter from right. Then they went. Then again they re-entered the stage. Grandmother, what did the children have to say? Narayan, they don't want a hotel on Dharmagiri. If it will ruin our countryside. Grandmother, I thought so. Children are wise. It is still not too late. We must take a stand. Now grandmother says that children are intelligent, so it is not too late. We have to do something. So we have to take action now itself. Or else big people with small hearts will swallow this beautiful village of ours. Otherwise the rich people will destroy our beautiful village, our beautiful mountain. Narayan, Mr. Dikshit is arriving tomorrow. They will start laying the foundation. We will stage a peaceful protest and submit a petition. Narayan says that yes, Dikshit is arriving tomorrow. Then we have to, yes, he decided to make a peaceful protest and decided to submit a petition to Dikshit. So the fourth scene is completed. Then next, fifth scene. See there. Scene 5. Curtain rises. Backdrop of mountains, a stream and trees. Dikshit is seated on a chair on one side of the stage and the Sagar on the other side. Sound of lorries, drilling and hammering can be heard. A procession of children and adults enters from the opposite sides. The children in the front row display a banner, listen to the mountain. They present a petition to Dikshit. Now what happens in the fifth scene? When the curtain rises, the background shows the mountain, rivers, then yes, trees. Then Dikshit is seated on the on a chair on the one side and the sagar is on the other side. Then sound of lorries, drilling, hammering heard. Then procession of children means group of children and adults were came there. Okay, enters from the opposite side. Then the children display a banner. Yes, listen to the mountain. Listen to the mountain. Then they came and they submit the petition. Then Dikshita reading it. What is this nonsense? Listen to the mountain. Here we are all set to build the biggest hotel in the state, one of the best in the country, and you people talking of mountain and rivers, rabbits and birds. Please, if you cannot understand the need for big business, don't interfere. Let us get on with it. Okay, come on man, come with the drilling. Let us get a move on. Then Dikshit says, what is this nonsense? Listen to the mountain. We came here to build a 5-star hotel, but you are talking about your mountain, rivers, birds, animals. Yes, if you cannot understand the big business, you don't interfere. Like that, who told Dikshit? Then he says that let's continue our work. Then Sagar says, keep working. Suddenly there is a terrible rumble and roar like rocks falling. It lasts for 30 seconds. Tremendous noise of horns blaring, voices screaming and shrieking. So suddenly what happened there? Yes, a large sound of horn, terrible sound. Yes, like rocks falling. It lasts for 30 seconds. So yes, it which shows of shrieking cry and screaming. Okay, then voices from off stage. Landslide. Dikshit and Sagar look around in panic. They stagger about, then run off stage. Then what happened there? Yes, Dikshit and Sagar, they afraid, they feared, so they ran away. Okay, they stagger. Stagger means unsteady movement of the body. Unsteady movement of the body, stagger meaning. Then Narayan says, he shouts, let us get help, we must help the injured. Hurry. The injured are carried away on makeshift stretchers by children. Some hobbles and limp. Slowly the commotion dies and the noise fades. So what happens? So the children, they bought stretchers and they take the injured people to the safe place. So the commotion means the noisy disturbed state came to an end. മനസ്സിലായല്ലോ ഇപ്പോ എന്താണ് അവിടെ സംഭവിച്ചത്? യെസ്, ഒരു റോക്ക് ഫോളിങ് ആ ലാൻഡ് സ്ലൈഡ് അല്ലേ. അപ്പോ ലാൻഡ് സ്ലൈഡ് ഉണ്ടായി. അപ്പോ എന്തായി? അവിടുന്ന് എല്ലാവരും ഇങ്ങനെ പറയുന്നത് കേൾക്കുന്നു, കരയാൻ തുടങ്ങി. എന്ത് പേടിച്ചിട്ട്? ലാൻഡ് സ്ലൈഡ് എന്ന്. അപ്പത്തേക്ക് ആരൊക്കെ? ദീക്ഷിതും സാഗറും സ്റ്റേജിന് ഓടിപ്പോയി അല്ലേ. പിന്നെ നാരായൺ കുറെ അവിടെ ഇൻക്ലൂഡായ കുറെ ആൾക്കാരെല്ലാം നാരായണനും ആ ചിൽഡ്രനും എല്ലാ കുറെ ചിൽഡ്രൻ ഉണ്ടല്ലോ അവരെല്ലാം രക്ഷപ്പെടുത്തി. പിന്നെ ദെൻ ഗ്രാൻഡ് മദർ സേസ് ഇൻ എ സാഡ് സ്ലോ വോയിസ് ഓഫ് ഓഡിയൻസ്, ഫൈനലി ദ മൗണ്ടെയിൻ സ്പോക്ക് ലൗഡ് ഇനഫ് ഫോർ എവറി വൺ ടു ഹിയർ. ഫോർ അവർ വില്ലേജ് ഇറ്റ് വാസ് എ ട്രാജഡി. 10 ഹൗസസ് buried beneath the landslide. 11 people killed, including 2 children. She wipes her eyes. I know it all along. Nature always speaks if we care to listen. Then grandmother says, she says that finally the mountains speak to everyone. Yes, it was a terrific, it was a tragedy. It was a big tragedy. So 10 houses were buried beneath the landslide. Then 11 people killed, including 2 children. So it's a big tragedy in our village. So she says that I knew it all along. Nature always speaks if we care to listen. If we care to listen, nature always speaks. So we completed the drama. See here in the next page, question answers are given. All of you read the drama first 2 times. Also read it properly 2 times. Then try to write the answer. Okay. Many questions are given here. So all should write the answer. 9 questions are there. Okay, students. Okay. Today I will stop the lesson. Meet you in the next class.